Shalom, all praises, glory and honor to Yahweh Bashim Yahushai, double honors to the apostles, and shalom to all the Akim out there, you know, not getting bugged out right now. And this is the brother Gadawan.
Banaya.
Oh, yeah, we'll call it not.
Khan, and just going to do a quick little lesson on this piece of shit on the screen right here. Poor light. I'm gonna play a little bit of it. Let's see this fucking Satan gets up. Here. When the cops shoot you down, I don't care, man. That's it, we praise the Lord. Talk about Mike Brown. That little trick that I shot in Ohio, man. The cop shot you. Shot that little trick, man. Wake you up, that little trick. We got our own fucking men. And bed bug infested sheets. Bed bug infested sheets. Out on the fucking streets. Calling themselves Hebrew Israelites. Saying they follow the word of the Bible. Our people feel proud when they find out the prophets are black. And then they join these niggas. Only to support the fact that a young man got killed, they said they praised the Lord. Alright, so obviously, he's getting mad, trying to stir up people's emotions, right? Being emotional. Because this whole thing between some nigga, the house of consciousness, alright, what's going on with GMS. And you see, look, it says right here, GMS niggers. Right?
Right.
And then you can see POLIGHT'S face, he's completely bugged out. He got demons on him, but he's stirring up every last demon out here, man. Bed bug infested sheets. So right, so that's what is that doing? That's just stirring on your emotion, and then we'll go into a couple. Of,
yep.
This thing right here, you got something to say? That?
Yep. He's basically creating a rally or support, being a ringleader himself, and it doesn't matter what religion or what philosophies you're into. He's just basically putting a target on Great Millstone because the brothers all across the world, they put up videos every single day, every week. So basically Great Millstone has flooded the World Wide Web with videos. So he's using the GMS as a catapult to push his own agenda and push his own debates by creating this ad. This is a big ad. And basically, he's a commercialist capitalist. He's all about mammon and money.
He's a sensationalist there, but I had a preacher.
All right.
So this is Matthew's 23 and started Matthew 23 and 33. He serpents, ye generation of vipers, how can ye escape the damnation of hell? Wherefore, behold, I send unto you prophets and wise men and scribes, and some of them ye shall kill and crucify, and some of them shall ye scourge in your synagogues and persecute them from city to city. Because it said on the comment board, you got dudes talking about, yeah, we're gonna come and kill these niggas. Right? Like, there's certain jakes that really have it in their mind. They want to actually go to the camps and kill us. You know? If it was up to them, they'd do that. You know? Polite. He ain't serious, but you got actual dudes that they're serious about that, because they're the same ones back in the day that stolen the prophets. Verse 35, that upon you may come all the righteous blood shed upon the earth, from the blood of righteous Abel unto the blood of Zechariah son of Berechiah, whom you slew between the temple and the altar. Verily I say unto you, all these things shall come upon this generation. O Jerusalem, O Jerusalem, thou that killest the prophets, and stonest them which are sent unto thee, how often would I have gathered thy children together, even as a hen gathers her chickens under her wings, and ye would not.
That's right. And then that's what that's, then that's pretty much what they're doing. They're killing us through the smear campaign. Now, I looked up the word smear campaign. It's a plan to discredit a public figure by making false or dubious accusations. And that's all they're doing right now, is making false and dubious accusations against the apostles.
saying we got bed infested sheets. That's a lie.
Yep.
Saying we rape 9-year-old girls. That's a damn lie. 12-year-old girl. That's a damn lie. Those are just
9 and 12. 9,
and he says always brings up the number 9 because that stirs up your emotions, just like the reason why. He said, oh, Mike Brown, a poor boy, because that's got all these people's emotions riled up. So, like, Bonnie, I was talking about his little rallying cry. He's rallying people against the prophets, man. That's what niggas used to do to get us killed.
Yeah.
So this nigga ain't no different than what he was doing back then. Him and Sa Nigga, the whole House of Consciousness, and the ISIS member, Gorilla Hebrew.
God.
All right? I'm just going to refer to you as the ISIS member. So back to this nigga right here, poor Light. You can see he has demons on him, right? And then check this out, though. There's a comment left about 39 minutes ago. Let me put this laptop in. And it's by Bobby McGee. You can tell he's a simple nigga, right? Just a retarded little... And the nigga says, damn! Bro Polite just sold me on this debate on February 8th. I'm buying that shit. Now you can't say I didn't support you, Sa Nutter.
Yep. Because it's all about entertainment.
Yeah, I got entertainment right here. It says that, see, they're selling this form of amusement. The action of providing or being provided with amusement or enjoyment. An event, a performance, or activity designed to entertain others. And now he's going to how, like, GMS are known by hypocrites, right? But they don't understand. Hypocrite just means you're an actor. And these dudes are straight up actors, man. Especially this guy.
Can you read the synonyms, too?
Polite. I'll read it right now. Synonyms saying amusement, pleasure, leisure, recreation, relaxation, fun, enjoyment, interest, and diversion.
Yep.
Diversion.
Yep. And like the elder apostle Raka did with the brother, the other elder brother, they went to the red herring fallacies, which is diverting the attention from the main, you know, the bigger picture. Which the bigger picture is who kills these boys, you know, who creates injustices and pushes his own law across the globe. It's this damn devil, Esau, so-called white man. But these guys aren't making videos rallying to get on the so-called white man. They'd rather get on GMS niggers, as they say.
Yeah. And people...
Also,
I... Go ahead.
I was going to say, also, we had the break of World War III. Like, them dudes, they ain't thinking about that. They're thinking about a goddamn debate on February and then just rolling up on men who are telling you, the truth, telling you about this war that's about to crack off. Because pretty soon, YouTube's going to be shut down. There's not going to be any street debates and all that bullshit or debates up in these auditoriums. That's about to go out the window, man. There's just all types of geopolitical moves that are being made day by day. And so yeah, this thing is a whole diversionary tactic from that. So you got dudes like that simple nigga on the comic boy, he's worried about a damn pay-per-view debate. Worried about being diverted from what's really going on, man. You might be watching that debate, man, and some damn troops come in his house. You never know, man. A lot could happen in 2 weeks.
Gone.
A lot could happen in one day. So
that's right, they're not talking about how in Ukraine there's mass death and graves being filled, and how Ukraine's going to run out of money in a few months.
Well, just like you said, they're just looking forward to February 8th, the next debate.
Right.
All right. And then you look over here, pretty much all this is advertising or propaganda, right? They're coming off all this propaganda, sensationalizing how evil they perceive us to be. And propaganda, right, says it's derogatory. Information, especially of a biased or misleading nature, used to promote or publicize a particular political case, cause or point of view. And they just have a have a political point of view because they're all about in the world. So they're going to use, just like all these presidents, these candidates, they're going, that's why they kiss little babies, right? That's why they go around helping old ladies across the street, because to the world that appeals to all these stupid, simple, worldly people. So they're going to say, oh, they're pedophiles, they're nine-year-old girls. They're going to say, oh, they're hypocrites. Like they would say, oh, he's a flip-flopper. See, this is just more propaganda. They're doing nothing that hasn't been done before. But you idiots, you stupid idiots, if you fall for it, the Most High is going to destroy you along with them. Hold on one second. Let's see. Logical fallacies. Because what these guys do, right, they go to debates. And what do you do at a debate? All you do is argue. Yeah, if you got precepts or anything, just bring them out or just call them out, and I'll put it up on the screen. This says fallacies. This is from english.purdue.edu. So it's a valid source, all right, you damn demons. Logical fallacies. Fallacies are common errors in reasoning that will undermine the logic of your argument. Fallacies can be either illegitimate arguments or irrelevant points, and are often identified because they lack evidence that supports their claim. Avoid these common fallacies in your own arguments, and watch for them in the arguments of others. So, this guy, this Edomite, is teaching a college class, right? They say we're uneducated. Well, you can go on websites and become college educated, right? You don't have to go there. It says here, you're supposed to watch for those type of arguments. So, I mean, have a critical thought. I'm going to go down these comments over here. These people are idiots, man. Hebrews been smashed on GMS. Them niggas is the worst. And these niggas just had the same arguments as the niggas on the damn video. Fuck GMS. Fuck you, GMS. Gabar and Taha are gotta go. These Hebrews of niggas are done. See? GMS is trash. Just a pack of niggas raised by wolves. Blah, blah, blah.
Really, everything that brothers are saying, it's according to the scriptures. You tell you in Jeremiah, you're not supposed to cry for these people. You know, the prophets, put curses on the people. The prophets of the forest. So really, brothers are walking in, the spirit of Yahweh Hashem Yahshua. Yet you got Sonnetta talking about God is going to kill us. And then that's the worst thing. This nigga, the man, who knows what he believes in? And then you got even guys on the comic board talking about that. Like, wait a second, Sonnetta, I thought you was a Hebrew. Now he's not. Even these niggas in the Black Consciousness Movement, they know that Sonnetta's so shit. He's talking about how he got people saying, well, I'll watch the videos, but I know these are mentally. Well, how the hell do you know? You don't read the Bible. You don't even know what that brother's really believing. All you're doing is taking, little snippets and focusing on part of what we teach, and because you let your emotions rule over you, man. But it's all spiritual. It's all spiritual. Because that's how you're going to be condemned by, talking about the truth, talking against it, having it in your mind that you want to come against it to the point to put it to death.
Yeah. Yep. Because that's the whole ill intention, is ultimately see us be destroyed.
And Polite and Sonnetta, they really want to see you destroyed, man. They want to see these dudes on the comic board destroyed, man. Not just us. They want to see Israel whether they acknowledge themselves as Israel or not destroyed, man. Well, these dudes hate so-called black people.
Yeah, they want to make money off of their ignorance.
Yeah, exactly. That's exactly what it is.
They're just capitalizing on they're just being white supremacists, They're capitalizing on the stupidity of the people, especially of poor, marginalized people.
Mm-hmm.
That's all they're doing. They're capitalizing on them. No, it's no different than what the so-called Jew does.
Yep.
Right, that's why they're using the same thing the white man does. And then let's go through them. We're back on our fallacies. Slippery slope. This guy uses this one all the time. This is a conclusion based on the premise that if A happens, okay, remember he's talking about the Egyptians, then they had the Hebrews in slavery. So that means y'all are Egyptians.
Right.
That's a slippery slope, so I'll keep reading it.
Yep.
Based on the premises that if A happens, then eventually through a series of small steps, through B, C, so on and so forth, X, Y, Z will happen. Two, basically equating A and Z. So if we don't occur, if we don't want Z to occur, A must not be allowed to occur either. Example, they do a stupid example here, but the example is, okay, Hebrews went into slavery under the Egyptians, and then you break down slavery, all these different steps, get to one. Now you're trying to equate being an Egyptian to being an Israelite, meaning black people are all Egyptians. This nigga uses this all the time. And this is what all these other idiots use all the time. Hasty generalization. This is a conclusion based on insufficient or biased evidence. In other words, you are rushing to a conclusion before you have all the relevant facts. Right? 8-year-old, 9-year-old, 12-year-old girls. Just being a hasty generalization. Just because you've heard it, that's why they say King James is a faggot, a homosexual, because they heard the rumor. So they're just going to repeat it. And that's a hasty generalization because there's no evidence or anything sufficient to base that as true.
Hearsay.
Con. What is this? Post hoc ergo propter hoc. This is a conclusion that assumes that if A occurred after B, then B must have caused A. That's just a simple one. Genetic fallacy. This conclusion is based on an argument that the origins of a person, idea, institute, or theory determine its character, nature, or worth. And they always use that on the scriptures.
Mm-hmm.
A cruel and vindictive God. Or they think that the
one...
God games.
God games. Or the white man wrote the book. The white man printed the book, so that's where it came from. That's where the origin of the Bible is. Or came from King James, who was a homosexual. Them niggas is using that all the time. So you can totally see all through these niggas' arguments, man. Begging to claim, the conclusion that the writer should prove is validated within the claim. Example, filthy and polluting coal should be banned. Yep. And that's what they're saying. GMS niggas need to be destroyed.
Yeah.
Everyone go on GMS niggas.
Bang on. Chase them off the street corners.
Just say something outright outrageous against them so people could jump on the bandwagon, right?
He's begging his claim.
He's begging his claim, right? Like, hey, you guys should want to do this too, because they should be this way. They need to be banned. They need to be chased. Chase these niggas off the corner. Let's get these niggas. That's pretty much what he's... That's a rallying cry.
That's why he needs to raise his voice and look all strung out, because he doesn't have any evidence. He doesn't have a reputable claim.
Yep.
It's an illegitimate claim. But he's got to sensationalize it.
And that's what these niggas are. They're experts in sensationalizing. You can meet a nigga on the... You can watch the first 48. You can see a nigga sensationalizing. But these guys are just experts at it, you know?
Yep.
Alright, circular argument. That's a good Hebrew. You shouldn't be dealing with this guy, because
you're learning how to argue like him.
Yeah, you're now you're polite putting you on game, because he cut you on his little thing, man.
Yeah, but it's just like when you go to school. You go to school, and the whole purpose of going to that school is to have you think like the white man.
Gosh.
It's just like the Black Consciousness movie. You learn to think like them, and then it becomes you not just what they call code switching, meaning, all right, you in school, and then you see where Esau's coming from, but you still keep your own mindset. But over time, that actually converts your mind over, man. And you start actually coming to the same conclusions that these devils come to. Why? Because you adopt their mindset. You know, this so-called Black Consciousness movement, it's no different.
Yep.
That's right. Hey, that's that's because of the propaganda that you fall for.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Circular argument. This restates the argument rather than actually proving it. It says George Bush is a good communicator because he speaks effectively. Right? That's what his name is talking about. Kemet.
Yeah.
Kim is good because it talks about all black people because it picks up the woman. And you hate the black woman. You hate the black woman.
Yep.
Right? And then them niggas use all of you. Either or, this is a conclusion that oversimplifies the argument by reducing it to only two sides or choices.
Mm-hmm.
Them niggas always. Yep.
He's polarizing, that's another way of saying that, to the two sides, very polarizing. So, which A.R. Lord, he's polarizing, you know?
That's right. But he's doing it in wickedness because he's saying, even though he's saying everybody needs to go up against these GMS niggas, he's calling out ISUPK at the same time. Why? Because he's just doing it for his damn February 8th debate.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, exactly, because on the truth side, it's only one thing, right? It's only one truth. But on that other side, that other pole, it's everybody who hates the truth.
Yep.
And whoever, you know, you could be a damn as you call them, black Khazar. You could be a damn Buddhist, and that's how you know that's the complete spirit of Satan, because when brothers on the highway of marriage, that's what happens. It's people who've never seen each other in their life. You know, they meet each other 5 minutes ago. Now you would swear they're best friends. Why? Because they're all in allegiance against the truth. They're all on one accord. And it's the same thing with polite. And anybody who's associated with him, and anybody who has in their mind that they just want to go against GMS. If you join in with some people who you don't have the same beliefs in, you may personally hate this person, but just because they hate the truth, which is coming from the elders of Great Millstone, you're going to link up with them. It's Satan. It's clear as day.
Yep, because he's over here promoting buying a video called The Homo-Gender Relationship. Come on, man.
Like, Shaka almost of all people, man.
Yeah, yeah.
Man, of all people, which that's obviously a defense mechanism. Everybody's getting on, not just within Israel, but even within that Black Consciousness Movement. So his defense mechanism is to put out a video trying to paint us as homosexuals.
Right. Okay? Right. Defense mechanism. And then there's no such thing as a homo gender relationship. What the fuck is that? That's not even like a concept, man. What the fuck is that? These niggas making up their own shit. But back to the fallacies, it says here, this is the main one they use, right? This is the main one, ad hominem. This is an attack on the character of a person rather than his or her opinions or arguments. And this is all they're doing every day, nonstop, on the comic boards, right now, as we speak, all right? In their fucking minds, and they go to sleep. This is what they going on in their minds, man. Because regardless of what's happening, okay, they can't break down doctrine, man. They can't break our doctrine. They can't go against the prophecies, all right, the scriptures. So they're going to go after men who are bringing it out. That's all they're doing right now. And see this fucking piece of shit gorilla. This gorilla dude opened the floodgates, right? Because he's such a heavy demon. But Sal nigga ain't even using him no more, man. He's hyping up his boy, man. The top of the House of Conscience, the main breadwinner for House of Conscience, the nigga Polight, man. Gorilla Hebrew, you ain't on a level to deal to be a demon like this nigga Polight, man. That's why the apostle said that. The apostle said that you know, we dealt with him, man. You can't deal with a nigga like this. Or any of them niggas, man. And because Gorilla Hebrew's a young guy, too. He's a novice even in the wickedness of these niggas. These niggas are heavy, hardcore demons, man. Yep, ad hominem. Go ahead,
Ad. I was going to say, I had a precept on what you were saying about black women being God. You said whenever you're done with it, it's just a story in Acts, which pretty much sums up these niggas, you know?
John, what is it?
So yeah, now Acts 19 chapter about Diana.
Oh, that's them niggas.
We should have some more on that fallacy.
Yeah, we'll keep going in on that.
Okay, fine.
Alright, ad populum. This is an emotional appeal that speaks to positive, such as patriotism, religion, democracy, or negative, such as terrorism, fascism, concepts rather than the real issue at hand, which is the second thing they always do.
Yeah.
Because what they're saying right now is that instead of the real issue at hand is how you're going to help black people, right? That's supposedly the crux of the issue, right, with this house of consciousness is how you going to save the black man? How you going to help black people?
Right.
Rather than actually, that's the real issue at hand. They're going to talk about 9-year-olds getting molested. They're going to talk about some weird Egyptian pyramid text, you know. She has nothing to do with what the real issue is. And that other real issue is how you going to take down the so-called white man. Because in order to really have any real so-called black liberation, you gotta get rid of the enemy. Anybody will tell you that. The top white supremacist scholar will gonna tell you that. Alright, next one is red herring. This is a diversionary tactic that avoids the key issues. Often by avoiding opposing arguments rather than addressing them.
Mm-hmm.
Now that's easy. These guys are none but do diversionary tactics. Straw man. The move oversimplifies an opponent's viewpoint and then attacks that hollow argument.
Mm-hmm. That's it. So we just come to the conclusion, well, look, they just believe in raping 12-year-old girls. That's the thing, you know. That's the thing you want to get stuck in your head.
Right.
When not keeping in mind that, you know, none of us have actually promoted brothers to go and rape 12-year-old girls, or even niggas in this world to go and rape 12-year-old girls. Just simply bringing out the fact of the matter that would happen back in the ancient world, and it's in the law.
Right, and then.
So, but
yeah, it's in the law, and but they attack the argument of that it's not right. You can't do that to 12-year-old girls, right? But it's in the scriptures. It's a known fact. It's documented history. You can watch any old film, old movies, they show you that. The apostles brought it out. So that's the straw man. That's the straw man they use. Right? And it has to be something. Go ahead.
I'm sorry. In modern day times, there's still instances where a much older man will get married to a much younger woman. You know? And parents are actually with it. You know?
Yeah.
And in fact, the parents will encourage the man to go and take the woman, to take her out of the house. But to these guys, since they're so Americanized, you know, they think of that as the most wicked, evil thing. Or she ain't even a woman yet. She ain't got her own mind. They go on to Esau's side saying, oh, her mind ain't even developed, so on and so forth. Which really, of all the things they can concentrate on, that's what they want to harp on. You know, all you believe in killing niggas and raping women, you know?
Yeah.
There's a lot of depth that comes out during sermons, during lessons, you know?
Right, they're trying to also sensationalize what we said, that we rejoice in seeing niggas like Mike Brown get killed by a white man, which is true.
Right.
There's nothing wrong with that, but these guys are, that's the straw man they're putting out there. Like, look, they say this, they do this, and they attack that. They can't attack the fact that, are we not Hebrew Israelites? They can't even go there no more, man.
Mm-hmm.
There's another one, moral equivalence. This fallacy compares minor misdeeds with major atrocities. So these niggas act like we just destroyed all black people. Look at these niggas. GMS niggas.
Mm-hmm.
So there you go, bros. If you don't see it by now, you ain't never gonna see it, man. This is the house of unconsciousness. Alright? I'll put the link up there for you bros. Lords of War. You know, and the, hey, wait, there's, you know, you can keep going through the comments, but back to the dude. He just said, hey, you got me sold. That's what they're here for. They're here to get weak-minded, stupid, simple niggas. Alright? Damn, bro. Polite just sold me on this debate on February 8th. I'm buying that shit. Now, you can't say I didn't support you, side nutter. So there you go. We can bring out as many scriptures, you know, as you want, really, to go to prove everything this guy was saying is wrong. But the brothers who watch these videos already know, you know. You got anything else to say, Cole?
Acts the 19th chapter. That's these guys.
Let's read it.
Scripture says, you know, they're moved with madness, you know. They're struggling with madness, and they're moved with madness. This is Acts 19 and 21. I'll try to read it. I'll read it fast. Actually, you know what?
I'll read it, and you break it down.
Okay, yeah. Matter of fact, you start at 18.
Alright, you can read it.
Okay. This is Acts 19 and 18. And many that believed came and confessed and showed their deeds. Many also of them which used curious arts brought their books together and burned them before all men. And they counted the price of them and found it 50,000 pieces of silver. So mightily grew the word of the Most High and prevailed.
Yeah, that's the time that we're in right now, and that's why these niggas are so ruled with madness. Because, you know, they're not buying all these damn documentaries, right? Buying these, you know, the DVD, all the red, black, and green memorabilia and all that bullshit, that merchandise. And the word is growing, you know?
That's right.
Yeah, the truth is right in their pockets. The truth is right in their pockets.
Yeah, and it's going, you know, it's beautiful because it's going to go on to explain that. So on that, he might be in the reincarnation with God Demetrius. He just might be. Keep going, Broker, sir.
This is verse 21. After these things were ended, Paul proposed in the Spirit when he had passed through Macedonia and Achaia to go to Jerusalem, saying, after I have been there, I must also see Rome. So he sent into Macedonia two of them that ministered unto him, Timotheus and Erastus, but he himself stayed in Asia for a season. And the same time there arose no small stir about that way, for a certain man named Demetrius, a silversmith, which made silver shrines for Diana, brought...
That woman's gone!
Yep.
Gone. Which made silver shrines for Diana, brought no small gain unto the craftsmen.
Okay, so Light said in his video, he straight up said, I promote the black woman's God. I'm with the black woman's God. Like, he said that, that's his shit, you know?
Yep. Hey, man, y'all watching out, you're gonna get more of your fucking kids, man. You're getting all upset over black babies dying. Well, guess what? Shortly after you blasting the name of y'all watching out, your kids got put to death. Right? Did not even speak on that? And it was right afterwards. So that shows that he's a reprobate. You should have took that like, damn, let me chill out on these Israelites. And, you know, I got, maybe there's something behind this. He doesn't consider that.
Well, he called out Yahusha at his name.
Mm-hmm. Did y'all pray to Yahusha?
So he knows. Yep. He knows, man. He knows the power that he's dealing with.
Oh, yeah. He already got jacked. His family already got jacked up, so... Now, he didn't already made that covenant with death. He's just full-fledged in Satan. That's why you can tell he got all the demons on him. But, you can go ahead, brother.
God. Which made silver shrines for Diana, brought no small gain unto the craftsmen, whom he called.
Right, so these dudes, they make This is modern day Crafter and all these other guys that promote that the black woman is God and uplift these nasty black women. And keep going.
Whom he called together with the workmen of like occupation.
Wait a second, whom he called together? They all go on whose platform? Sound better?
Yep.
Yep.
Keep going.
Whom he called together with the workmen of like occupation, and said, Sirs, ye know that by this craft we have our wealth.
And that's how they make their money. That's their basis, that black woman being God, uplifting her ass. And that's how they get their wealth, because a lot of our people are into that. I know niggas that got that picture of a big ass, big muscle-bound Jake holding a globe and a woman bald-headed sitting down. So people, they play off of that, man. They know that spirit is heavy, specifically amongst Judah. So they play off of that. That's a part of their craft. Because really, their craft is they're hucksters, and they use the Queen of Heaven worship as they sell it for
them.
Keep going.
Sirs, ye know that by this craft we have our wealth. Moreover, ye see and hear that not alone at Ephesus, but almost throughout all Asia, this Paul hath persuaded and turned away much people, saying that they be no gods which are made with hands.
Right, see, look, these niggas all around the black community, talking about they don't fuck the black community. It's the same thing, man. It's the same exact thing. They're saying the black woman ain't God. And I'm paying for the black woman, man. I'm paying. I teach the black woman is God. Saying that there be no gods which are made with hands. Because they were making shrines to the black woman back then. Because Diana, she's a so-called black woman. So now, they just... and I wouldn't be surprised. They actually sell that at those events, man. Actual shrines of the black woman, man. But they sell them posters, It's the same concept.
They make those hand signs of the Vesica Pisces, the Bartholin gland.
Yep.
It says that they be no gods which are made with hands, so that not only this our craft is endangered to be set at naught, but also that the temple of the great goddess Diana should be despised, and her magnificence should be destroyed, whom all Asia and the world worshipeth.
Keep going.
And when they heard these sayings, they were full of wrath and cried out, saying, Great is Diana of the Ephesians.
Okay, say one thing.
Yeah, good.
That's exactly what this guy right here was doing.
That's
you can see it in his face. You can see it. This dude he put on a show, man. For black woman is God, because like, that's his. He said that's what he's rolling with. He ain't gonna go away from it. That's what he's with. And here's got some of the titty milk. Bitch. Alright. You notice how her nose is always broken off and all these things. Why? Because she was a black woman.
Yeah. And I mean, you can stop there. I mean, there's a lot on the story brothers can read. But that's the gist of it.
Gone. Yeah, you got anything else to say, bro? Anything else?
One last script.
Alright, hold up.
It's Proverbs 14. And... 15.
All right.
This is Proverbs 14, verse 15. The simple believeth every word, but the prudent man looketh well to his going. So if you fall for all these red herrings, ad hominem tactics, then you're simple. If you buy into that, the debate. But the prudent man, men of the Lord that study the scriptures, you find out that these guys are just actors, the hypocrites. And they're liars. They're all manners of evil.
Keep going.
says, a wise man feareth and departeth from evil. So, yeah, you're not supposed to be kicking it with these guys or giving in to their madness. But the fool rageth and is confident.
And you can see Polite is, he is super sure of what he's saying is the truth, right? And he's, right? You can't convince this guy. Whatever he's doing ain't the truth, right? But see, he's raging. He's a fucking fool.
He's moving with madness.
That's right. So yeah, keep going.
Okay. It says, a wise man feareth and departeth from evil, but the fool rageth and is confident. He that is soon angry dealeth foolishly, and a man of wicked devices is hated.
Right, and so pretty much all you guys who get mad at GMS real quick, you're fools, okay? And then Sonnetto, that's why we hate you. We hate you, Polite, because you're a man of wicked devices, all right? Son nigga, you're a man of wicked devices. You don't give a damn about black people, but you don't. And it shows it right here because you call GMS niggers, all
right? Right. But what about the black community? What about black family?
Oh, yeah, death to the black community, all right? You're going to get really mad because I'm not even a so-called black person, but who cares?
Right? Sean Nett is not either.
Yeah.
You should be mad at Sean Nett. He's a so-called Dominican, man. You should be outraged, man, at the racism of this so-called Hispanic.
Yep, because you know damn well, at the end of the day, he's going to refuse the fact that he ain't a nigga from the States, you know?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Damn black Hispanic. So, yeah, with that, you know, death to America, death to Polite, the whole house of unconsciousness, you know, and death to this place, death to America, all right? Shalom.